saving more money at Menards.
If you guys haven't been to Menards, we love Menards. We are getting this new rust-proof black, matte black shower curtain rod, curved shower curtain rod, because ours is rusted from when we didn't have a strong enough fan in the bathroom. So now we got that. Here is the paint that I picked for the bedroom accent wall. I will tell you, it is going to have an accent wall. And a 4-pack total of light fixtures for different areas in the home. We need them. We love Menards, don't we?
Yeah, I mean, it's not bad. It has a lot of different things.
And they even have a food section. Ribs. 15-11? That seems high. Everything you can pretty much imagine. I actually had an interview here when I was looking for a job. Thinking about being like a morning opener person is not stuff. But God had a different plan for me, and it was to remain a nurse, and I'm so thankful for that. But I didn't get the job here. Cotton candy balls. That's interesting. Ooh, that sounds good. And they always have like really interesting candies and stuff. Oh, they got the packs of reusable. Oh, that's actually a pretty good sized bunch of these. For $5.97, you get $1 a piece. I think that's a good deal. Do we want to maybe get some of these? They're reusable, you just wash them.
That's up to you. I don't know if it'd be something we would actually use or would be.
And then there's an 8-pack of this smaller one, which that's kind of nice too. I think I'll get one of each of those if that's okay. And then they got covers too for your paint. I like that idea. So then you, oh, problem is hopefully Roman doesn't throw them away though, because at first he's going to be like, he gets, oh, he doesn't even take this. It'd be Liv. Yeah, it would be. She'll appreciate that too. Liv loves that kind of stuff. For, you know, things that help the environment.
They got dog stuff here.
Oh. We found out, what, the other day that we're definitely getting a puppy, so we're very excited about that.
Hopefully January or February.
January or February. They are moving forward. But I guess the only hitch would be is if they had all girls.
I looked up the other day that the boxer normally has 5 to 7 average puppies. So.
Yeah, so the odds would be, yeah, there would be at least one boy in there. Because we definitely want a boy, I think.
Yeah, we do.
Hello friends. So I am going to be doing a Goose Creek haul for you. If you don't know what Goose Creek is, it is very similar to Bath and Body Works. They have lotions and body fragrance, you know, mist, body spray, body cream, and candles, just like Bath and Body Works. But at least when I bought, and I went back to just recently, and there's still some awesome deals. $1.99 for my lotions that I got, and the candles I got were somewhere between $5 and $10. So let's get started. I want to show you guys what I got. So I'm gonna turn you around. So their packaging is decent. I already cut the top just so I could not have to hassle with that while I was on here. Well, it looks like this busted off of it. But, oh yeah, there's candles, a couple candles. There's one candle in this box, but here we go. We have got, so they're nice full size, just like Bath and Body Works. This one is burlwood and oak. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull them all out, and then I will... And then I'm going to smell of them. So we'll put one of each kind. Because I don't know how many different kinds I got. Cherry blossom. These are big. I feel like they're almost a little bit bigger than Bath and Body Works. Wildest dreams. I have no idea what these are going to smell like. Very cute packaging. I mean, maybe not quite as cute as Bath and Body Works, but still cute. And $1.99. I mean, really? Black cherry. And oh, sunshine. That's cute. And then the candle in this box, because I think I got two candles, but maybe I just got one, is this is super cute. Fireside S'mores. So Bath & Body Works has a comparable one to this. Let's see. It's a 3-wick candle, so it's the size of that. And let's smell it. Oh, that's nice. That really does smell like s'mores. Wow. So that'll be interesting to see how much throw it has. Oh my gosh, you guys. I'm sorry. You're sitting here looking at my junk over here. Let's take this and put this somewhere else. My mail. Okay, so this is the... Oh, one more lotion. We've got Half Moon Bay. And then I'm going to take this box and throw it over here out of the way so we can open up the bigger box. And I will tell you grand totals at the end and everything like that. So packed much the same way. This one's a heavy one. They've got a new bunch of candles. They're cute themes. The one I saw they had today, these are like Halloween, like Scooby-Doo. The one I saw was a Little Debbie snack cake. It was like Christmas cake scented, I think. So that could be really cute and interesting. Okay, so once again, we got this stuff. And look at that. Look at all these. So I spent, I think, right around $100. I'll put my grand total on the screen. And then we can see how many I got total of everything. And this is all lotion. So I guess I just got one candle, which probably is fine to start because, you know, you never know if they're going to be any good, have good throw. Lotions I needed, though, so I wasn't too concerned. I got Cozy Kitten. I think all of these are different. This is literally like all of the different lotions almost, besides a few that they had at Goose Creek. So we're just gonna start with these over here. Like I said, the candle's super cute, smells great. When I get my invoice, I will break it down, let you know how much that candle was. I think it was, though, like I said, it was definitely less than $10. And super cute packaging. So we're just gonna go through the different scents then. So I already showed you those. And then we've got Cozy Kitten. I don't know what a Cozy Kitten smells like, but Lavender Vanilla, Scarlet Apple, Pile of Leaves, Lush Getaway, Apple Palm Twister, Perfect Day, Champagne Bubbles, Carnival Cake. Ooh, that sounds good. I don't know about for a lotion. That'd be a good candle, though. So as you can see, guys, I pretty much bought one of every scent they almost had. There were still probably a good 10 to 20 scents I did not buy. But this was a good portion of the amount of different ones they had. We've got Sunday Drive. Meadow Sweet Avocado. Tropical Daydream. That'd probably be a good one. Although I don't like coconut scented lotions. I don't. It makes me like a sunscreen. Hibiscus Fruit Punch. And then I'm just going to pull these out but not put them in front of me so you guys can just see. Oh, this one's super cute. Unicorn Candy. Eucalyptus Raindrops. Weekend Getaway. Dragon Fruit Splash. Pina Colada. Ooh, although that'll be coconutty. I love pina coladas, though. Melon Picnic. Carnival Apple. That sounds good. Oh, I love the packaging on this one. Pineapple Cake Pop. Oh, I think I'm going to like that. I love the smell of pineapple. Watermelon Lemonade. Bath & Body Works has one similar to that. Marshmallow Waffle Cone. Beach Dreams. Macintosh Apple. So I have three different apple scents. And Paradise Tea. So we're going to start with the ones here in front of me. I'm going to turn this off for a second and open all these so we can smell. All right, guys. So here are all of the scents. I took off all the plastic packaging on the top. And here's the three I liked the most. So we've got Scarlet Apple, Dragon Fruit Splash, and Wildest Dreams. First impressions. So I didn't put you guys through watching me smell each one. You guys obviously can't smell it also, so that would just be pointless. So I will just tell you, first impressions, I'm not super impressed. So they all smell about the same. And I can tell by the smell of most of them that they probably won't be a very strong scent, or like Bath & Body Works. Like when I buy Bath & Body Works and wear it, it lasts all day. It's, you know, that's why I love it so much. I feel like it lasts better, like the lotion does better even than the spray. It really gets into my clothes and it just smells so good. It makes my skin feel so good. There's something about these with the texture of the bottle. I mean, I will say it's cute. It's like embossed on the side and says, I'll have to flip the camera around. It's got a backwards, but Goose Creek. So it says it on the side, which is cute, but I don't know. The packaging seems thin and cheap. Here's what I will say next. They do smell good, most of them, but they're only $1.99 a piece. And I looked today and they're still $1.99 a piece. I mean, you get 8.4 ounces. So I buy Suave lotion. And if I compared this, I think that would be very comparable to a brand like Suave. So, I mean, you know, it's definitely going to beat Suave in scent. So I look at it that way. There was no loss here. Would I prefer Bath & Body Works? Yes. Do I want to? The prices at Bath & Body Works have gotten so insane, but I'm not. That's why I went on a search looking for an alternative. So I smelled them all. This was, like I said, my three favorites. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pick one out of all these. I'm going to re-smell them again. That one smells kind of manly. Wildest Dreams. I don't think I want that one because I don't want to smell manly. I don't really like manly scents on women, for myself anyway. I mean, it smells good. At least it's strong and it smells different. So it's still in my top three. Dragon Fruit Splash. Let's smell. It smells nice and fruity. And then let me see. Scarlet Apple. I just squirted myself in the face. Okay, if I had to pick one, I'm going to pick Scarlet Apple. There's something about it that reminds me of a Bath & Body Works scent that I really like. So I am going to rub this all over. And I'm trying to think. I wish I could remember which Bath & Body Works this reminds me of. I would post that. So you, if you like that scent, you would like this scent. But I really just can't think which scent. The candle smells good. I smelled it again. It is a super cute packaging. I mean, very cute. Nice lid, three wicks. But is the throw going to be good on this? I don't know. Smelling it again, like, I feel like now that it's been opened and aired out a bit, Kind of smells like milk. Like sweet milk or something. I don't know. So I'm going to burn this for an hour or two. See if the house fills with the scent. And I'm going to put some of this scarlet apple on and we'll see how it lasts. All right, guys. I'll be back. All right, so I have it next to a small Bath & Body Works vanilla pumpkin candle. And I will say, I just put the lotion on, the one I chose, the apple one. And I really like it. It smells super, super good. Well, my goodness. I wonder if this is going to light. There it goes. All right, so I'm going to light this, give it a couple hours, and at least an hour anyway. Right before I go pick up the kids from school, I'll blow it out and we'll see if we smell it. Pretty though, very pretty. Okay, so I went and got one of my Bath & Body Works ones that I have left. So I was running low on these. And that's why I bought the Goose Creek ones. And these are 8 ounces. So you actually get 0.4. You actually get 0.4 ounces more, which, I mean, that's obviously not that much. But still, that's nice. And like I said, the packaging to me feels cheaper. The scent seems lighter. I will say the feel of it on my skin feels more oily than Bath & Body Works. But I do like the smell, so I'm curious to see here in a couple hours. I'll let you know. I'll let you know in an hour whenever we see if the candle, how much throw that candle has. In the end, the final verdict was that the lotion was okay. It wasn't as strong as Bath & Body Works, but for $1.99 a bottle, it was definitely worth that price. It did last, just not as long as Bath & Body Works. I'm not crazy, however, about all of the fragrances from just smelling them from the bottle. So we'll see about that. And then the candle was great. It had really great throw and smelled really good. So I don't have any complaints about it. It was $8.99. I'm going to see if I can attach my order here. It's going to be kind of small. You'll have to blow it up, I think, because it was taken, you know, off my phone. So I'll either do that or I'll try to figure out another way to do it. But anyway, so yeah, I would say go for it. Definitely try them out. Definitely worth the money. All right, guys. Tonight, I am making chicken fajitas.
We are making chicken fajitas with peppers.
Roman's first day at school is today. And Liv, what did you think, Rome?
It was amazing. I'm glad I'm getting a bigger Chromebook. It's the same size. It just has a case.
Oh.
And I get to keep it.
Awesome.
At home.
That's nice.
I can't do that in second grade, though.
Yeah.
By the way, guys, comment down below if you guys cook your peppers.
Do you cook your peppers? Anyway, this is a 3-pack of colored peppers, orange, yellow, and red, and 2 onions, 2 medium onions. I'm just going to let those get tender and browned and caramelized a little, and I don't have all the ingredients I would want to have for this. I don't have fajita seasoning. I just have taco seasoning. But this chicken is chicken fajita chicken, so I don't... Yeah, it's got fajita seasoning on it, so I probably won't even need to add that, or very little of it. And then, which this is a nice shortcut. This is from Sam's, and it's worth it for me anyway. But you can also just cut up a few chicken breasts, however many you need for your family. I'm going to use up what's left of this cheese, and we've got more in there. Some kind of, if you like cheese on yours. And I don't have fajita-sized taco shells. I just have these soft taco-sized ones. That's fine. And then, like I said, peppers, onions, which the onions I already cut up. They're not even in the picture now that I'm thinking of it, but that's all right. And then I got 2 kinds of salsa. Some romaine for me, or any kind of lettuce if you want lettuce. And then I want sour cream, but we have no sour cream. So that's it. And so you're going to cook these till they're tender. Kind of, I'll let them sit for a little bit and like caramelize a little while they're steaming with the lid on. I've got it on an 8. I could probably turn that down a tad to 7 maybe. So I'm just going to cook this for, my guess is 10, 15 minutes, maybe not even that, 10 minutes maybe, to let them get soft. and then I'll add in the chicken because it's going to just basically be warming up. I'm not going to be, you know, cooking it per se. So I might definitely do 10 to 15 then on the peppers, because unless you like them a little crunchy. So I will come back and show you when I add the chicken. All right, so now I am going to grab our bag of frozen fajita chicken. They have steak too, that would have been good also. So I'm just gonna dump this right into this because the peppers are pretty much done. This is 2 pounds from Sam's Club. And I forgot to mention this, but I'm sure, you know, most of you assume you would put a little oil in the pan before you start cooking those peppers. Maybe a couple tablespoons, quarter of a cup maybe. All right, and then I'm gonna let that steam for a minute because it's frozen, and then bust it up, and then I'll show you when it's all mixed together, and we'll decide if we're gonna add some seasoning. I know I'll definitely add garlic powder and maybe onion powder, so those two things, yes. All right, guys. I don't know if I showed it or not, but I cooked the chicken then in with that. I think you guys saw me do that. I busted the chicken up in a little smaller pieces. Is it good?
Very good. I love fajitas.
Mm-hmm. And then their fajita flavor. It said I already have fajita mix, like seasoning on it, but I just added a little bit. I did end up adding a little bit of the taco seasoning. I think it kind of needed it.
Very good.
Thank you.